Xbox 360 versus PlayStation 3 versus Nintendo Wii, the current video game console war. I read time and time again, which is better, PS3 or Xbox 360, PS3 or Xbox, PS3 or Xbox. See what's going on here? PS3 or Xbox, there's just only between those two. Let me remind you that the console war is based on sales. Which company is selling the most consoles? In the 90s, it was the Super Nintendo versus the Sega Genesis, and it was an intense battle that had the Super Nintendo winning with over 9 million units sold over the Sega Genesis. Nintendo wins. In the mid and late 1990s, Sony PlayStation came out, surprised the gaming world with its awesome machine, and overshadowed the Nintendo 64 and trampled over the Sega Saturn. The 21st century introduced the GameCube and the PlayStation 2, and their power, especially Sony's, totally overshadowed the Sega Dreamcast to the point that Sega was like, alright, we're calling it quits, and they pulled the plug on the Dreamcast. And Sega had a head start. Dreamcast came out before the 21st century. It had some time to develop, but nope, it just wasn't meant to be. And on the other end of the spectrum, Microsoft says, hey, we want to make a console too. And the critics were like, really? Are you please, Microsoft, seriously, Xbox? That's what you're coming out with? And what happens? The Xbox proves to be a formidable opponent in the console war. Well, what do you know? Everyone, and I mean everyone, had to own a Nintendo Wii. It was like the biggest thing ever, and everyone wanted to have it, because it was like, oh my gosh, motion controls, and Zelda's gonna be a launch title. Everyone had to have it, right? It was the biggest thing on campus, and you couldn't find it at any store after it was released. It was almost impossible. People were selling it on eBay for like $800,000. It's like insane. And today, we're like in 2011, 6 years after it's been released, and people can care less about the Wii. Now, I'm only basing this off of what my friends have said, how I've seen how the Nintendo Wii has been treated in gaming publications, most notably in like IGN or GameSpot, and also what people have been saying in internet forums or in the comments on YouTube. They've just turned their back on the Wii like it's yesterday's trash. And the fact is, it's winning the console war. And even though it's winning the console war, it doesn't matter. Because I've seen time and time again, people treat it like it doesn't exist. My friends are saying it wasn't what they wanted it to be or what they'd hoped it to be, so they've totally dismissed it. In gaming publications, like I said, IGN or GameSpot, especially IGN, like right now they're doing this Super Smash Bros. Brawl, bringing it back. We're bringing back Smash Bros. Brawl and we're playing it and stuff. It's like they're doing that because they think there's no other games on the Wii to like cover, so they're just filling in space. Even like you go on the Wii page and there's like all Nintendo 3DS stuff or what we think Project Cafe is going to look like, so we drew up some drawings of it. Hello, there's still Wii games coming out, and you should be covering games that maybe have come out in the last 6 months. Maybe do some retrospectives on those, or you know, talk more about Kirby, talk more about GoldenEye 007. Like, Machinima's doing these Black Ops things I see on YouTube in the front page every freaking day. Like, oh, top 10 kills. Machinima presents top 10 kills in Black Ops. Why aren't you guys doing a top 10 kills in GoldenEye 007 or top 10 kills in Black Ops for Wii? I mean, there are Nintendo, you're missing a whole audience. You're like missing this whole audience of dedicated Nintendo gamers. Not just from like myself, I'm speaking for, yes, children, kids, teenagers, and adults that are playing the Wii, and you're just missing out on that whole demographic that just owns the Wii. And other than that, you know, YouTube comments, internet forums, you know, if anyone ever mentions the Wii, like they say, oh, it's PS3 versus Xbox 360, if someone ever mentions the Wii, you know, it'd be rare. It'd be totally rare if we didn't see, and the graphics suck, in the same sentence. I mean, that's just the same thing that happens every time I see it. I made a comment just the other day saying that GoldenEye 007 for Wii is better than Black Ops, and then someone wrote under my comment in response, oh, are you a kid? And it just harkens back to the video that I've already made about Kirby's Epic Yarn. It just kind of goes back to that whole thing. And Mario Galaxy 2, where Mario Galaxy 2 was the highest rated game of last year. it could have won Game of the Year awards at the VGAs, which I guess a lot of people don't take seriously anyways. We already talked about that. And that was overlooked. Same thing like in the movie business. Toy Story 3 nominated for Best Picture. Will it ever have a chance to win Best Picture? No. Why? Again, we talked about this. It's because Nintendo, at this point, is seen as for kids, right? But it's still a gaming machine, and hello, it's winning the console war. So, what's gonna happen now? We'll see. So aside from everything I've been talking about, the point of the whole matter is that Nintendo is winning the console wars of this era. They're the top dog, whether you like them or not. They have over 85 million units sold. Xbox 360 has over 50 million units sold, so they're in second place, and PS3 has around 50 million, so there's a little tight race between those two. But as soon as the Nintendo console hits shelves next year, what happens? This era is over. We have a new generation. This, of course, is if this Wii 2 or Project Cafe, whatever they're calling it, if it's actually more powerful than the Xbox 360 and PS3 as Nintendo claims, then definitely this era of gaming is over and we're starting the new era with Project Cafe. So, Nintendo will win this console war if Xbox 360 and PS3 doesn't pick up. But now the Wii is being sold for $149 with Mario Kart as a pack-in game, so wow. I can only assume that Nintendo sales will pick up throughout the year, and of course, Christmas time, it will go up. We have games like Twilight Princess, Animal Crossing, Wii Sports for only $19.99. Now that, of course, Mario Kart is the game packed in with a Wii, they're selling Wii Sports for the first time on its own. Nintendo's winning this, guys. I don't know what to say, but if a tree falls in the woods, does it make a sound? If Nintendo wins the console war, does anybody care? Not if they're too busy fighting over which is better, 360 or PS3. Fighting over that they're both playing the same games, except they're using a different controller and a different machine to play them on. So, what do you think about that?